All right. Mm-hmm. Today I'm going to be working on a bike computer that I've got. It's working intermittently and doesn't quite pick up the signal. And I did a bunch of troubleshooting. I thought it was the battery was low, but it's actually because of what's called a read switch inside of here. Now, so this is the Cateye Velo 9. I've owned it since 2016, so it's about 8 years old. It's done pretty well. Inside of here is what's called a read switch. And I found out I could just pull this off. And then this is what's called a read switch. And a read switch is a switch that opens or closes when you bring a magnet nearby. So this here is a magnet. There's four magnets on here. And it'll actually close or open the switch when it goes by. This one is a normally open switch where you can get normally closed ones. This is the read switch that I'll be replacing it with. So I'll just show you, just to show you how it kind of works and how this works as well. On these computers, essentially bike computers, they've got these two contacts that touch the two contacts on here, which then go down to this read switch, and the read switch will it will close. So what I need to do is replace this. Fortunately, it's just two little spots that I need to desolder, and then I can reattach this new one. So I'll show you how this new one works. So I'll turn this to detecting a short. Cool. So here's the read switch. So it's currently open, but when this goes by, and so that's how a read switch works. Cool, now I just need to desolder it, solder the new one on, and we're good to go. So I've just done some soldering off camera. I've put my read switch in, and I'm just testing here to make sure that it's still working. And this tests for continuity, and sure enough, with my helping hands, holding that there, I got my magnet. And there's no contact, it's open. And then if I bring the magnet close enough, then it signals it. But the real test will be on the bike. And so just got to reassemble it, and then I'll take it to the bike and we'll see if it all goes. So this is the magnetic sensor. And the read switches inside, I've just put it back on top. This portion you didn't see before, this just needs to be cable tied onto the bike itself down here. And so it'll be cable tied about here, and then with the bike computer, you should be able to see, I should be able to hook it, start turning the wheel, and as the magnet goes by, we'll see some of the numbers showing the speed of the wheel going around. Real fast. Sweet. So it's fixed, ready to go. Just need to cable tie all of this back onto the bike in the right spots. And fixed, done.